लेसन नंबर 12, इंट्रोडक्शन टू द एसिडन बेसिस. अंडर दिस लेसन नाउ वी आर मूविंग टुवर्ड्स द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द लेसन, दैट इज द एसिड्स. सो व्हाट आर एसिड्स? एसिड्स आर सच अ सब्सटेंसेस विच गिव्स एच प्लस आयन्स इन द सोल्यूशन. मीन्स एच सी एल इन साइड वेन वी डिसोसिएट्स इट गिव्स H plus and Cl minus ions. Here it is hydrochloric acid in the aqueous, and here it is H plus and Cl minus ions are present inside it. And where there is a H plus is coming, these are called as a These are called as a acids. And where there OH minus comes, those are called as a bases. You will get its information in the next information is. So examples of some acids. So which are the examples of some acid? The hydrochloric acid. If you see here, here H is the main content. Nitric acid, here also H is the main. Sulfuric acid, that is H2SO4. Carbonic acid, that is H2CO3. In the cold aerated drink inside, this is present. Means that Coca-Cola and all inside it. Ascorbic acid, citric acid, which is present into the that is a lemon inside, and other foods inside, these acids are present, ascorbic acid and the citric acid, and acetic acid is present in the vinegar. So these are the some of the examples of our acid. In our daily life, our daily diet contains few natural or organic acids. Our diet contains few natural or organic acids. They are mild in nature. For example, we are drinking the buttermilk, lemon juice, then tomatoes. Inside it also, the acids are present. They are mild in nature and hence are not harmful like mineral acids. Means other acids are there, H2SO4, means sulfuric acid, nitric acid, hydrochloric acid. It falls on our skin, the skin burns. This much strong are there. But whatever we are taking, these natural organic acids, these are not so harmful like mineral acids. So first of all, the vinegar. In this vinegar that we are using in the most of that Chinese foods are there, inside it vinegar they are using. Okay, so in vinegar which acid is there? Acetic acid is present. Next, our orange inside which orange that we are eating, fruit, inside it ascorbic acid is present. Next, tamarind. In tamarind, tartaric acid is present. Okay, tomato inside oxalic acid is present. That curd is there, curd or buttermilk, inside it this lactic acid is present, and in our lemon inside citric acid is present. So these are the acids, these are called as a natural or organic acids. These acids are the natural or the organic acids, and the hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, nitric acid, these are the mineral acids are there. Okay, now the next point is what are the properties of acid. Just one property we had seen, that is when it dissociates into the water, it forms the H plus ions. Acids are sour in taste. If you see these examples, which are the examples, if you see this lemon, curd, tomato, tamarind, orange, these vinegar is also, these are sour in taste, all are sour in taste. Acid molecule contains hydrogen, that is H plus, as a main constituent, acid react with metal to form the hydrogen gas. When these acids are there, when it reacts with the metal, it forms the hydrogen gas. Okay, for example, suppose this is the H2SO4 is there, or HCl is there. When it reacts with the metals, any metal you can take, it forms the salt and water. It forms the salt and hydrogen gas. It forms the hydrogen gas is liberated from this. Okay, next it is acids react with carbonates and liberate CO2. Means these acids are there. When it react with carbonate, means CaCO3, these carbonates are there. When they are react with this, then what they liberate? CO2 gas is coming out of in that. For example, our baking soda is there, sodium carbonate. When we are adding this lemon juice on it, the sodium, that sodium carbonate is there, means baking soda inside. If you are adding the lemon juice, you see the effervescence, means bubbles are coming from it, okay, and from that bubbles which gas is coming out, that is the CO2. The blue litmus paper turns red in acid, that is also important. If you take the red blue litmus paper, okay, it turns red, and its opposite base inside, that is blue, red litmus paper, turns blue. So these are the properties of acids. So first property is the, they are sour in the taste. They give H plus ions as a main constituent. Acids react with the whom? Metals, and liberate hydrogen gas. And acid react with carbonates and gives the CO2 gas. And blue litmus turns red in the acids. So these points you have to keep in your mind. What are the properties of acid? Their taste is sour. They are what? H plus is the main component, reacts with metal, hydrogen gas liberate, react with carbonates, CO2 gas is liberating, and blue litmus turns red into the acid. Now, what are the uses of acid? First of all, some of the just acids I told you we are using as a food, we are eating. It is important for our, important parts of our diet also. And here, some other are there, which are means organic only. That organic or natural acids only we are eating, other we are not taking in our body. The acids are very dangerous, so be careful. Don't take taste of acid, don't take smell of acids. Acids are used in the production of chemical fertilizers, okay, for the production of chemical fertilizers the acids are used, and by using these chemical fertilizers the soil become acidic because of these reasons. That is, the chemical fertilizers are made from the acids are used in the production of explosives, bombs and all are there, or that your what we are saying, that crackers are there inside it also, small acids are using. Oil purification process inside also acids are using. Medicine inside acids are using. Dyes, paint, for the production of these dyes and paint acids are using. Okay, next it is the hydrochloric acid is used for the preparation of different types of chloride salts. Next it is the dilute H2SO4, means sulfuric acid, is used in the batteries of electric cell. When the farmers, they are using mostly this type of, means at night time, at night what happens, they are going to water their farms, so they are using such a batteries. Big batteries are there, or the vehicles are there, they're also using these batteries, okay, vehicles inside also. Next it is dilute hydrochloric acid is used for the sterilization of the water. Sterilization process is there inside it, that hydrochloric acid is used. Acid is used for making a white paper from the wood pulp. That paper we are using in our notebook inside, that for that production of this, what, for this production of this white paper also we are using acid. So here the uses inside what we have to write, that is, acids are used in the production of chemical fertilizers, then for in the production of explosives, in the production of oil purification, production of dyes and paints and medicine inside. Then especially hydrochloric acid is there, it is used for the preparation of different types of chloride salts, and again it is used for the sterilization of the water. And this dilute H2SO4, that is the sulfuric acid, is there, it is used in the batteries, in the vehicles, and that another batteries are there inside it. Acid is used for making the white paper from the wood pulp. Okay, so that is about this. Now causticity of the concentrated acid and the base, what the causticity of the concentrated acid of and base. So dissolution of the concentrated H2SO4 in water generate large amount of heat. Okay, so what happens when we are adding water and the sulfuric acid, at that time large amount of heat is produced. Okay, so here therefore dilute concentrated acid is slowly added into the water. That is very important. You have to add acid, if you have to take a test tube inside it, add water. First of all put the water, then you have to put one here glass rod in this way, and from that glass rod a drop of the acids you have to add inside it. Instead here we have to take the H2O and here acid we have to from the add from the above. But instead of this, if you are taking acid here, okay, if you are taking acid in the test tube and if you are adding the water from above, then what happens, large amount of heat produces and that test tube breaks, and that all the the severe accident will be takes place because of this activity. So whenever we have to dilute the acid, we have to take water into the test tube and slowly we have to add the acid inside it. Okay, so therefore for dilution of the concentrated acid, it is slowly added to the water. Never add, that is very important point is given here, never add water in the concentrated sulfuric acid. Water we are not going to add into the sulfuric acid, but sulfuric acid we have to add into water in a small quantity. It will produce emerges heat and cause explosion, and explosion takes place. Bases, like which are the bases? Sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide are strong. They are strong. NaOH and KOH, potassium hydroxide and NaOH. Their concentrated solutions burn skin as a decomposes the protein in the skin. Means this concentrated solution is there where it is very dangerous and it burns our skin. Use your brain power question is there. The iron knife shines better if you cut the sour fruit like lemon, raw mango. Why? So when this iron knife is there, when we are keeping it as it is, what happens? First of all, it get oxidized and the ferrous oxide is formed on its surface. What it forms? Ferrous oxide. And this ferrous oxide, what happens? It reacts with the lemon, means citric acid from the lemon. Otherwise, the raw mango inside also, the acid is present. Inside it, what happens? The reaction takes place and that what happens? It get cleansed and then it looks so shiny. We have seen the mineral acid are harmful for the body. Mineral acid means H2SO4, HCl, these are the mineral acids. Organic acids means lemon inside, vinegar inside, vinegar, these are the organic acids. Above it is given, these are the organic, okay. And the H2SO4, HCl, these are the what? These are the mineral acids and they are very harmful. However, several organic acids are present in our body and in plant which are useful to us. Okay, with this, just now I told you some organic acids name. With this DNA, that is DNA, that is deoxyribonucleic acid, means acid is present in our DNA only, and this is the what it carries the hereditary characters to the next generation, as you know that. Present in our body decides heredity properties, means how you are, like your mother, like your father, like your grandparent, it is decided by this what? The hereditary characters, and these hereditary characters are present in the deoxynucleic acid, means acid inside also, inside only they are present. Next, proteins. Proteins, which are the part of our body cell, okay? Just now I told you when this acid falls on our skin, what happens? The proteins from that place, from the skin, the proteins burns. Protein burns, and that's why what happens? That skin, what? It turns black on it. What happens? Means the proteins are present in our skin. So here it is written, proteins are part of our body cell, are made up of from the amino acids. There also acids are present, and those which acids are there? Amino acids. And next, fat of our body, fat is there, it is made up of from the fatty acids. Means these acids are present, okay, in different places in our body also some acids are there. Just now I told you deoxyribonucleic acid, RNA also, ribonucleic acid, RNA is also there, hereditary properties it carries. Amino acid is present in the skin and the fatty acids are present in the fats of our body. So that is about the acid that we had seen today, the part, that information about the acid. Now the next part is the base part is there. The base details we will see in our next lecture. So today we are going to stop here only. The next part of the lesson we will see in our next lecture. So today all of you just learn the this substances and and which acids are naturally organic acids which are present inside it. These names you are going to learn, this definition, this acid reaction, properties of acid, uses of acid, and this all you have to write and learn. Okay, uses and the properties of acid, this and that. Okay, so that is your today's homework. So all of you completed, base part we will see tomorrow. Okay, so today we will stop here only. Okay, thank you and have a good day.